this video we're going to combine two images using the gradient tool and a layer mask. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images in the video description. When Gimp is open, we go to File and click on New to open the New Image dialog box. For this video, we will go with the default size of 9020 by 1080, so we can just click OK. This is the canvas on which we will work. Now we go back to File and click on Open as Layers. Here we can search for the first image and open it. Depending on the size of the image, we have to make it bigger or smaller to make it fit on the canvas. When we zoom out, by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel towards us, we can see the yellow dotted lines. They indicate the size of our image. This image is much bigger than our canvas, so we first have to scale it down. Go to the toolbox and hit the Unify Transform tool. Click on the Configure tab, go to the Tool Options menu, and then click on Reset All Tool Options. Click on Reset. In the Tool Options, under Constrain, we check the option Scale. When we scale the image now, the proportions stay intact. Make the image opacity somewhere around 50. Click in the image. Because we have brought the image opacity down, we can see the underlying canvas. The layer is now invisible. In case we want to move the dialog box out of the way, we can click on this icon. Then we can, by click and drag, move it to wherever we want. To get the fixed dialog box back, we have to click a random tool and then on the Unified Transform tool again. Click in the image again. Go to one of the corners, click and hold in the square, but not in the diamond, so the square lights up yellow. We can now drag the image in a way that it fits on the canvas. When you click and hold in the image, we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the whole image. When it looks okay, we can click Transform. The layer automatically becomes visible again. And the font changes from bold to normal, which tells us that this layer now can have transparency. Zoom in a bit by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel away from you. Now we go again to File and Open as Layers. Search for the second image and open it. This second image too needs scaling and repositioning. Because the Unified Transform tool is still active, we can just click in the image to bring up the framework. And again, by click and hold in the square, which lights up yellow, we can scale the image. Make sure not to click in the diamond, because then we change the perspective. When we hover over the different nodes, we can see at the bottom which action we can perform. Now scale the image. Make sure that there is enough overlap to make the gradient. When this is to our liking, we hit Enter or click Transform to apply. This layer can also have transparency now. In this image, we will make the gradient. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Make sure that white full opacity is checked and click Add. Go to the toolbox and make the gradient tool active. Choose the custom gradient. Make sure that left is dark and right is light. If not, we can click on the reverse button. Click in the image and draw a line from left to right to make a gradient. When we activate the second layer, the green dotted lines disappear and now we can still see the edge of the top image. And that's not what we want, so we have to make some adjustments. Make the top layer active again and make sure that the layer mask is selected. We can see a white border around the image or the layer mask, which indicates which one is active. We can hit Ctrl Z to undo, but we can also move the begin and or the end point like so. Now we can even make a diagonal gradient. When we press and hold the Ctrl key, the line snaps every 15 degrees. We can make it exact horizontal, which makes the gradient exact vertical. When we hover over the line, there appears a point. we can grab this point and make the gradient a bit harder or softer, like so. When everything is to our liking, we hit enter to confirm. Click on the bottom layer to get rid of all the lines. And there it is, two images in one with a nice gradient. I hope this helps and that you like the video. If so, please be so kind to give it a thumbs up, maybe post a nice comment and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching.